Hi Libra, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do your reading for April 15th through the 21st. This is for Libra Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus signs. Now keep in mind this reading may or may not be for you. Not every reading is going to be for you. Check out your other, you know, your rising sign or your Venus sign or your Moon sign if this doesn't resonate. Let's see what comes up. We're going to use the Celtic cross just for this segment. Then I'm going to go back to my regular spread. This is for Libra. What do we have for Libra? And we're going to go back around. We're going to start out with the initial pull, and then I'm going to go back around to get clarifiers. Libra. Working hard. You are working hard, aren't you? Well, the challenge is stepping into your new life. Right? I think that you're trying really hard. You may be trying to make progress. You're trying to start over, perhaps, or you're trying to let go. You may be working hard to complete a cycle in your life. And maybe it's not easy. Maybe it's hard to let go of the emptiness. But I think that you are making progress, and your efforts are probably paying off. Okay? Eight of Wands reverse. There's been a delay, though. There's been a delay. There may be a block in communication. You may not be receiving a message or communication that you want to hear. You may not be receiving, you know, you may not be moving forward as quickly as you should be. Right now, you know, if this is in regards to another person, there's no communication or there's delayed communication or there's blocked communication or there's just none. King of Wands, you could be dealing with an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Now, this person is in charge. This person is very strong, strong-willed, decisive, very decisive. It's like when this person makes a decision, the decision has been made. Very strong, strong-willed individual here. Very decisive. We're going to have to get another card to go with that to see where we're at. Uninteresting. Okay, if you look at this one and this one, see what's mirroring each other. This is lack of progress. You may be at a stalemate right now. I think that you guys have been working hard to complete something. You've been working hard to find closure, right? Something may be coming to an end. Or has come to an end, and you're trying really, really, really hard to move on from it, right? You're doing the best that you can do to move on, all right? Ooh. Well, there you are, Empress, down here in your approach or your power. You know, love yourself, nurture yourself, take care of yourself at this time. You are a beautiful soul. Don't forget it. Now, this is giving birth to a new life. Consider this a blessing. Whatever this closure is, and I know that you're probably like, it ain't no freaking blessing. It is a blessing. Trust me. The pain that you have endured is bringing you a blessing. Trust me. The Empress gives birth to a miracle, and that is no joke. She gets that baby in her hands, and it is a miracle. You think about that. So yes, you are going through some pain. You have went through some pain. It has been probably the worst pain you've dealt with ever. In the end, you're going to have a new life. You're going to receive a blessing. Trust the process. A true blessing is going to come out of this pain. Believe it. You may need some drugs. No, just kidding. Just kidding. I don't know where that came from. You know, sometimes you do need drugs, but I don't know where that came from. I don't advocate for drugs, honestly, I don't. But when you're having a baby, I do. But sometimes I gotta keep my mouth shut. I don't know. I mean, I don't advocate for it, but, you know, I know the pain is so extravagant. That's what I'm trying to, that's where that came up from. The pain is so insurmountable. You might feel like, you know, you need to escape from this pain. That's the better way to word it, okay? So, you know, you may feel like this is insurmountable pain, put it that way. That leads to a blessing. Now I'm going to, I know, anyway, look at what's coming. Love, a partnership. A union. The Three of Pentacles. Ooh, strength reversed up there in the outcome. You may feel like you may have a dip in energy. Oh, I'm just being honest with you. I mean, this is a week about relationships, right? With the full moon in your sign. Absolutely. You are dealing with some pain in regards to closure of some sort of relationship. Now, this relationship could be with anybody. This relationship could be a parent, could be a husband, could be, you know, a family member, could be anybody. But I feel as though there is some, I think there's a separation that is coming or has come. And it's going to make you feel weak. It may make you feel sick. Okay? You may feel sick over the what you're dealing with. I feel as though it's going to steal your energy. You may feel down in the dumps. I have to be honest with you. This is the outcome. Lack of strength. You may not be able to master your emotions. Put it that way. You may be overly... I mean, it is the full moon in your sign this week. And it's about partnerships, you know, and you're all about relationships. You're all about partnerships. Your emotions might be a little out of whack this week. You may be crying. You may feel overwhelmed. You may feel like you're not worthy or you're not good enough or who knows what. That's not true. That's not true. You're beautiful, okay? You're beautiful. You're kind. You're compassionate. Your people admire your compassion. People see your compassionate nature. They see your ability to nurture others. They see your true self. Okay, trust me. You may not see it. You may feel like you're not good enough, or you may feel like you're not worthy, or like you did something wrong. But the outside world sees you as the Empress. Okay. They see your kindness and they see your beauty and they see your gentle compassion and they see your strength and they know what you've been through. So you are respected for who you are. So don't lose that thought for a minute. Okay, so I feel as though relationships and partnerships are going to be heavy on your mind this week. I mean, it is. I mean, there's no doubt about it with that full moon and that, you know, in your sign this week, you know, the no forward movement, the no communication, the no closure, you know, you've put in so much and now, you know, it's over, it's done, and you didn't get what you wanted. There was no victory and success, and I feel like you may feel like you did something wrong. No, I don't think you did. I think that the universe cut whatever this was out of your life because you have a bigger blessing coming and you just don't know it yet. So that's what I see. But anyhow, let's go back around. your challenge is allowing yourself to, you know, start over. You have a major new beginning here. Don't delay. Damn lights. We're gonna go back around. You guys have been working really hard. Trying so hard to keep composure, right? To prove yourself. And now it's judgment day, right? You gotta make this call. You've probably been working hard, hoping for a reconciliation, hoping for a chance or whatnot. And it's not happening. There's no progress being made. You may have been holding on to hope that there was going to be a reconciliation. Now, this is a card of release. This is a card of absolution. This is the card of the truth. You guys have been holding on to the memories, clinging to the past. And there may be a lot of memories, you know, right at the surface, because it's time to bring closure. Okay, it's time to close out this partnership, that whatever it is, and you know what it is. Okay, there is a relationship here, whether it's with your partner, your romantic partner, or your parent, or your sibling, or whoever it is. It could be a work partner, could be anybody. There's a closure here. There's an ending here. There is. And I think that, you know, it's time for you to release it and stop clinging to it. You've been working hard. I think you've been working hard to, you know, fix it, right? You've been trying really hard to fix the situation and hoping, you know, that for this reconciliation. But there's no reciprocation. There's no balance and harmony. And, you know, there's no love being reciprocated. And I feel like, you know, it's an emotional loss for you. I think that you are definitely going to be feeling emotional this week. And I'm just going to be honest with you. I think that it's a very emotional time where your feelings and you might be all over the place because something is coming to an end or has come to an end for real. Something that you have put a lot of effort into. Something that you worked hard to make successful. But no matter what you did, it just didn't work. And I feel like, oh God. I feel as though you may be angry, you may be upset, you may be resentful, you may be losing sleep, you may be really stressed because there's nothing you can do. There's no forward movement, there's no communication. Communication has completely ended, there's no nothing, okay? And I think that you're really sad. You may feel guilty, you may feel really depressed because maybe you've been cut out of somebody's life hastily. There could have been a hasty halt. You know, a halt or stop in communication or a hasty departure. I feel as though you guys are probably going to be upset. And I'm just being honest with you right now. I feel like you may shut down. You may shut down and become cold. You know, you may withdraw from communication. You may want to hide almost. Like, I don't want to talk to anybody right now. You may be like, just leave me alone. I can't deal with people. I need to be alone and deal with my own pain. So you may just want to, you know, retreat. I think that with the moon, this moon, I'm telling you what, there's stuff going on behind the scenes that you don't even know about. This has all happened for a reason. There's hidden forces here. There's something that has happened that you, for a reason that you don't understand. Okay, this has happened for a reason. There's a reason that you can't see, that there's a reason why something has come to a halt. There is a reason. And it's definitely, this full moon is going to be very, very emotional for you. Very, very, it's going to bring up a lot of memories. It's going to bring up a lot of feelings. Okay, we got memories here, feelings here. It could make, you know, you could go through a stage of anger. You think about the stages of grief, okay? Anger is one of them. And when you lose a partner, you go, whether it's through actual death or not death, you know, you go through those stages of grief. You do. And sometimes you go through them more than once, Okay, so I think this full moon is going to bring up the grief that you have endured, and you are probably going to, you might be confused. You may feel like you want to escape. This is escape. I think that you may want to be alone. You may want to be alone to deal with your feelings, okay? I have to be honest with you, okay? This is Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Could be a father, could be a partner, could be a boss. Oh, that is not a good card, okay? So this is the end, okay? death. Okay, this is it's an ending. It is an ending. It's a release. This ending needs to happen so that you can start over. Endings bring new beginnings. It's a time of transition. It's a time of transformation. It's time for you to let go, regain your focus, and take the lead in your own life, right? It's time for you to be the boss of your own life. It's time for you to, basically be the boss. You're in charge. Take charge. This ending is going to give you the ability to take ownership of your future. That's what it is. I mean, we definitely have an ending here. Up here. Lack of victory, lack of success. Presently, you may be feeling very emotional. I mean, the King of Cups reversed. This is not able to master your emotions. You may be feeling like you absolutely positively need to withdraw from communicating with people. You may feel like you can't right now. You may feel like you are an emotional wreck. I've got to be honest with you. And I think it's because something is gonna probably make you feel like you weren't good enough, or you didn't do the right thing, or you weren't successful, or you're gonna blame yourself for something, and you can't do that. You can't do that. I feel like, you do have a better opportunity waiting for you. I think that, I mean, this is a new exciting opportunity, a new adventure. It's gonna lead you down a new path. So I feel like, you're gonna be very emotional about going down a new path. I think that's what this is. I think about starting over, taking a new approach, about taking the lead, about, I think that's what this is. I see you guys really in your feelings this week over starting over doing something new, over this new adventure that you are kind of like forced to go on because there's no progress, or there's no forward movement with whatever it is you tried so hard to hold on to. I think that you guys are about to embark on a new adventure that you are being pushed on to. It's like and you're uncomfortable with it. I don't think you like it at all. I don't think you do like it at all. Ace of Swords reversed over here in the future. This is not wanting to, right? It's like you don't want to. I don't want to take a new approach. I don't want to. I feel like there's definitely going to be a drop in communication. These cards fell out and I didn't even see it. Letting go. I think you're gonna receive a message that you don't want to hear. You are going to receive a message that you do not want to hear, and there's gonna be a serious. It's gonna be seriously hard for you to communicate. I don't think you're gonna want to communicate with anybody, honestly. I think you're gonna be an emotional wreck. I gotta be honest with you. I do. I think this Libra full moon is going to cause you to shut down your communication. I think that you, or the person you're dealing with, if it's not you, it could be the other person. Somebody is cutting all communication to a complete halt, and that is no joke. Communication is coming to a complete halt with somebody. It's like there ain't no more communication coming through. The ties are being severed. I feel like somebody is deciding that they're going to let go. They are letting go. Somebody is letting go. I think that there's going to be some unexpected conflict, and you probably need to, you're probably going to set up your boundaries. You're going to probably put a barrier up around you to protect yourself. Okay? You're probably going to be like, no, I don't want to. Yeah, this is insecurities. Feeling insecure. You may feel like you're a victim now. You may feel like you're a victim of this circumstance, and you may well be. It feels like somebody has cut you loose, or you've cut them loose, and now you feel like you're a victim of this circumstance, and you may feel like you've been left out in the cold, right? You've been ghosted. And you have. You have. It feels like you have been ghosted. You've been left out. You've been left out in the cold. And, you know, I think that it's going to cause you to shut down. I think it is. I got to be honest with you. I don't think this is all peaches and cream. It's definitely not. I think that, you know, you're going to feel, you may need some help. You may need some help. You may need, maybe you need some guidance, okay? The Hangman reversed. I think you're going to need time. I think that you're going to try to stall. I think that you're going to need time to be alone, to deal with your insecurities. I do see needing alone time. I see that you're just not wanting to involve yourself. I think that you don't want to deal with this change, but you can't, it's out of your control, honestly. I feel like this change is happening whether you like it or not. You can't be stuck here anymore. It's time for you to go your own way, and I think that's what this is. I think this full moon is coming to bring closure to a relationship that has, you know, come to its end. And it's very emotional for you as you are being forced to let go and start on a new life adventure. Definitely a new life adventure. And it's like you're being pushed. You don't really have a choice. And I don't think you like not having a choice, right? Who does? Look at this. The Empress with the Ten of Swords. Like I said, new life. She gives birth to a new life. Endings bring new beginnings. Same with the Death card. This is like the end of what was. The Ten of Swords. The end of mental conflict. The end of turmoil. The end. This ending that you are experiencing right now, that you are going through, that you have to accept, that, you know, you have to stand up and you have to walk away, you have to keep going, is going to lead you into a new life. You're going to receive a blessing. One of the blessings you're going to receive is strength, okay? It is. Self-love, self-worth. You're definitely going to want to go within this week. There's no doubt about it. I see you guys wanting to be alone, to gather your thoughts, to harness your power, to figure out what the next step is. We definitely have some sort of cycle or completion that is happening for you. That is going to send you probably maybe into a like a retreat mode. Like I need to go within. I need to go within for this time to start my new life, you know, to cultivate my new life, you know. Now that I'm forced to, now that I'm basically pregnant, even whether you're pregnant or not, you think of it this way, you're impregnated, now you got to deal with it. You know, you got to deal with it. You got to deal with what's happened. So, you know, and through that journey of whatever amount of time it is, you know, there's all kinds of changes going on. So I think that you're going to have to really take a step back. I'm being honest. I think this week that you're going to have some sort of completion that comes about in your life with a partnership that you have held on to that you didn't want to end, and it's over. And you don't have a choice about it. And I feel like you're really emotional that you put in all this effort and all this work, and you may feel guilty like you didn't do enough or whatever. No, you did all that you could do. It's out of your control. This is the challenge. This is the challenge, okay? The world card. This is the universe. The universe is in control. They say you had nothing to do with this, okay? This was the universal plan. The universe is in charge here. So, you have somebody coming to the rescue. You do. This could be your knight in shining armor. It's a knight of pentacles. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. This person is a planner. This person is slow. But when they come with something real. So you could be, somebody could be coming to help. Maybe they're coming with money or an offer of some trying to help you. They could be coming with a gift. Or they could just be coming to help you feel more secure, maybe. I mean, this person is very loyal and secure. I think that somebody will be coming in to help you in some way, to help you with your mental conflict, to help you with your turmoil, to help you get unstuck. It's like this is your hero. Seriously, I feel like somebody's going to come in, somebody's trying to come in, or this could be the person that you're stuck on. This is the environment, and this is stuck. This could be the person that you are stuck on. Oh my goodness. Yeah. Uh-oh. You guys could be stuck on... in a one-sided relationship with this person. This person may be moving, maybe that's the message that you receive, that this person is getting married or they're in another relationship or they have moved on to another relationship. Oh my God. So that's what this is too. I think that you guys are... may have been in denial about a relationship, and you may be, because you are receiving a message that you don't want to hear with that Page of Swords, there's no doubt. And I can see that you're going to feel really upset. You may receive a message or something from somebody that says, you know what, you've been waiting and holding and waiting for this guy to come rescue you, and he's got another relationship. This is a one-sided thing, and you're holding on to a, you know, you're not being honest with yourself. You're not being true to yourself. This is unfair. I understand. This is unfair treatment. I think that you are treating yourself unfairly by trapping yourself, waiting for this person to come. When I think this person has already moved into another relationship. Yep. So I feel like... yeah, you guys have been waiting for somebody. You have. You've been waiting for an offer from somebody. Waiting for an apology, perhaps. Waiting, just waiting, 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 waiting. And I think whoever you're waiting on, they see it, but they're not taking it for some reason. They're not telling you the whole truth. You're dealing with a liar. I think you're dealing with a player. I think you're dealing with a player who has lied to you, and they probably, you know, tell you that they're coming with something, but they're really in another relationship. I think you're dealing with, and I think that's what this comes with. This comes to is that you're stuck on somebody that's in another relationship. You've been waiting for them to come to you. They see that you're offering it, but they're not taking it. This is a one-sided relationship, and you're cheating yourself of balance and harmony by holding on to waiting for an apology from somebody that's given their attention to another partnership. That's what I see. I feel like you're dealing with somebody who is giving what they have to somebody else, and I think that you may be hoping that this person is going to turn around and give it to you and come rescue you, but this person, they're not taking what you have. You know, and you're not being honest with yourself. I think that this is a terrible injustice to who you are. I think you're cheating yourself. You're deceiving yourself. That's what I think. I think that externally, you know, you're going to receive the truth. The truth is going to come out. This is the truth coming out that you've been holding on to, hoping that you are going to receive justice from this person that is giving what they have to another person. So I really feel like you guys have been cheating yourself, and the truth is going to come out, and it's going to break your heart, unfortunately. Now, I don't know, I think we got somebody that's heading in a different direction. You guys are at a crossroads. Now you have to make that choice this week. You have this opportunity to work with somebody else, to go on a new direction, to start that new adventure, and to leave the past behind. To literally drop that baggage, to drop that weight, to make a conscious change in your life. That's what we got here. We have breaking free. This is freedom. You guys are being broke free. It's like the universe is doing it. It's like the universe is cutting you free from this partnership that is really no more, that you have probably held on to hope that this person was going to come through with an apology and an offer, and you may receive some message that this person is in love or has engaged or something to somebody else, or they've moved to be with somebody else. They've went to be with somebody else. They're no longer in your life. They're not coming back. And I think that's where all this emotion is coming from. All these feelings, all these memories are coming up because it's that realization, and that is realization. I put in all this work for nothing. And that hurts. It does. So I feel like you guys are really going to have to, and to heal, you have to, it is about bringing up those old wounds, honestly. And a lot of people don't want to bring up those old wounds. They want to bury them. But if you don't feel them and you don't accept them, you don't heal. Kind of like this. You have to deal with that pain without drugs or with drugs. Or I don't advocate for drugs, but when I think about giving birth, I mean, whatever, you know. You have to deal with the pain to get the blessing, put it that way. Overall, you're probably not going to be happy. You may overindulge. You may do something that you shouldn't do. You may try to escape the reality of this pain that you are dealing with, because the old idea, the old way, this is the death of an idea. It's over. That is the death of a night. It's over. It's like a death. It is. A lot of readers are afraid to mention it. I'm authentic and I'm not going to hold nothing back. That is the death of an idea. And it's going to make you feel like you did something wrong. You didn't. You're definitely gonna. I see this week you needing time alone to recover from this painful ending that you have now accepted the reality of. And that's what I see. There's a reality check here. It's time to release, forgive, let go, and start over. And that's what I see. I see a painful, emotional week for you, Libra. And I am not going to pretty it up and pretend that it is all peaches and creams. This is your full moon, and this is exactly what is supposed to happen. I'm sorry. You have a new life waiting for you. That's what the universe wants. It wants you to go down that new path, and you have to deal with these wounds. Playfulness. To recapture romance, allow your inner youthful spirit of fun to shine. It's time. It's time. It's time to have fun again. It's time to live again. Stay optimistic about your love life. Positive thinking and faith will bring you romance. Stay positive. I know you're not going to be able to. I think, good luck. Good luck. I mean, if you can, great. But it is very emotional time. Let your friends help you. Ask for and accept support from others. You're going to need it, but I don't think you're going to want it. You're going through a huge transformation right now, a transition in your life. And it includes a significant loss, it does. Accepting the loss and starting over. And it's painful and it's emotional. And I see you guys wanting to retreat and be alone to deal with this huge change that is happening. And that's what I have. I'm sorry. I can't. This is reality here. Good luck.